Good morning, ladies and gentlemen. It is really a pride to me that I am being the Municipal Health Officer of this area and Director of Health of New Delhi Municipal Council, where this summit is going on. I am indeed obliged by you that you people have come to this area and you have shared all your thoughts how to keep the environment clean. First of all, I must congratulate Dr. Asha Seth. Dr. Asha Seth, an eminent gynecologist from Canada, but educated from my state, that is UP. I really very, very happy that people from my state has gone up to that level, and now she is representing one of the government of Canada. She has, in a brief, very clearly gave the message that the environment, which is the most, we have to keep it very clean and pure. If we inhale the clean and pure air, then only our body can remain clean and pure. And when our body is clean and pure, then only our thoughts can be pure. And after that, we can do only the pure and good deeds. Dr. Asha has clearly mentioned that in Canada, it was observed that the home pollution, that the pollution from the houseworks which was being generated, it led to problems to the pregnant ladies, and it also led to premature deaths. So you can imagine that even in the house, when air pollution is there, and when we go out and in the open, on the roads or open environment, so much pollution is there, what can it lead to our health? She has given the message that Canada, being one of the best developed countries in the world, they are also in the problem of pollution. Then what about the developing and the underdeveloped countries? Here we are sitting, where the density of population is 1,000 persons per square kilometer, and in the daytime when it increases, log of vehicles is increasing, lot of activities are going on, lot of factories all around. You can just imagine how the pollution is increasing. She also mentioned that the government of Canada is one of the leading governments and one of the leading partners in the whole world who is thinking about the environment pollution. They have made the Environmental Pollution Act, so as in my developing country also. India has also made the Environmental Protection Act, and they have also formed a National Green Tribunal. I must tell her that we have also formed a National Green Tribunal. The National Green Tribunal is deeply concerned with the activity of the persons as well as the communities, that how the pollution is increasing and what steps they should take to control pollution in India. Pollution, she has also mentioned that lot of studies are being done, lot of monitoring is being done. And I remember the day, it was way back in 1995, when I was called by the World Bank, and I, along with the World Bank, published a paper in the American Journal of Agriculture Economics, that environmental pollution mortality in New Delhi, this subject was studied there, because it was second of its kind in the year 1995. It was second of its kind. First was done in Philadelphia, and second study was done in New Delhi, and it was with the World Bank. That study clarified that pollution, when there is increase in pollution, the death rate on that day was really high. You can very well think that pollution not only affecting our respiratory system, but it is affecting the whole body. Not only the respiratory diseases were there, but also the cardiac and other diseases were there. So this was a very, very important observation of that study. But after that, lot of studies are being done. And I must share one thing to Dr. Asha Seth, that even in the time of Commonwealth Games, when Canada was also participating in those games, in New Delhi, we had a pilot project, and we brought a an air pollution control machine from Italy, and it was installed in this area where you are sitting. This is the heart of the city, that is Connaught Place area, and we found that in a span of about 6 months, 1.2 kg of suspended particles were separated from air. You can just imagine how much suspended particles are there. She has also mentioned that the petrol consuming vehicles are one of the main constituent of creating pollution. The sulfur constituent of gasoline is one of the notorious elements. The nitrogen dioxide, it is also one of the notorious elements. So these all things, when they gather in our environment, in air especially, and the carbon products also, they all pollute the atmosphere. And I must say that in my developing country, there was previously we were burning coal for making that all household walks, and now we have switched over to CNG, we have switched over to our gas. So the pollution level was little reduced by it, but there are not many other things. Like factories are always there. When our country is developing, everywhere in every community you will find one or the other company which is manufacturing or producing some product, and all these products, when give some byproduct, it goes into air and increase pollution. Dr. Asha Seth has clearly mentioned that not we are spoiling our life, but we are also spoiling the life of the generation which will come after us. As she mentioned that the pollution was directly affecting the pregnant ladies, and there were premature deaths, and you can very well imagine that if a lady living in environmental pollution and she is giving birth to a child, what can be effect on the child as well as on the mother. So all these things have led us to think today that what we should do the best to control our air pollution. National Green Tribunal has also mandatorily done it that no garbage should be burnt in New Delhi. They have also directed that no leaves or no wood shall be burnt in open. They have also mentioned that the garbage so collected in Delhi, because Delhi is producing about 8,000 metric tons garbage per day, and this garbage is going to the dump site only. But now, for the first time, we have gone to waste to energy plants. We are now planning how to control the disposal of garbage. Now we have come to the policy of reduce, reuse and recycle. So all these things, they are not only here, but we have also learned some things from the West also. We have started segregation of garbage, and now the segregation of garbage has led to reduce the garbage which is going to the dumps. So all the dump sites around the Delhi, there are about 4-5 sites in Delhi, they are emitting methane. That is also being a challenge for Delhi government. We are also planning how to control these collected garbage dumps. And now I must say that Dr. Asha Seth has mentioned one more thing, that Canada is having some technologies how to dispose garbage in a proper manner. Even Japan, I visited Tokyo, I found waste energy plants in Tokyo, and they are wonderful. And when I compared the waste energy plant from India to Japan, I found that the precipitation mechanism for the suspended particle in air was too good in Japan. So we would like to share all the experience of Japan people who are here, and I welcome them in my country to share their experiences how to control air pollution. So these 2 days, I think we all will join together and we will speak about the air pollution and how to control it, and to give the community the best possible standard of air. And now I request all of you to please, if you are having any question to Dr. Asha Seth, you are welcome.
Hello. My question is to Dr. P.J. Sharma.
Sir.
My question is that this hotel belongs under the NDMC.
Sir.
I'm sitting with the pollution meter.
Sir.
Right in this five-star hotel, the PM 10 is between 120 to 200.
Sir.
The PM 2.5 is from 104 to 174. And PM 1 is from 78 to 122. And the noise level is 90
dB
in this particular room. Somehow we feel that in a five-star hotel, there should be a regulation by the municipal, like corporation like UNDMC, that we must maintain whether they put down purifiers, air purifier, because when we come and go to a five-star hotel, we expect that at least the room where we are having a conference is absolutely noise and air pollution free. Can this regulation be thought by the NDMC, as you talk about the health, can there be a regulation? If that happens, it will be a good service to the society.
Sir, New Delhi Municipal Council is definitely a regulatory authority on these hotels. We have firstly tried on the solid waste management of this hospital, of this hotel. Secondly, we have tried to combat the liquid pollution, liquid waste pollution. And thirdly, we are coming to the air pollution. And in this hotel, because this hotel is air conditioned, it means there is definitely filtering systems there. And comparatively, we are getting better air than the outside environment. Of course, you have mentioned that we slowly and slowly we are going towards that. There we have made two committees, that is one is Central Pollution Control Board and second is Delhi Pollution Control Committee. All these board and committee, they are formulating certain formulations and which we are going to regulate in these hotels. And in these hotels, definitely as they are five-star hotels, they are also very conscious about it. The person whosoever comes in this hotel, they try to provide the best environment. So, they are also conscious, the regulatory bodies are also conscious, and two mechanisms, that is CPCB and Delhi Pollution Control Committee. These two are monitoring the air pollution and the liquid pollution in these hotels. We have also deployed our SCPs and effluent treatment plants, and also for the air pollution they have provided some other filter. So, but it is not at present, we are not making everything mandatory, but it is optional. But we definitely think it over to make it mandatory.
Thank you, sir. Any other questions to Dr. Seth, Dr. Sharma?
Thank you very much. Thank you.
Thank you, sir.